Yeah.
I thought you said 5301. Hey, fuck you! Why don't you give your fucking ass and do it your goddamn self? I'm out here busting my balls at 2 a.m. and for what, a couple G's? Shit won't even pay for the therapy it takes to get through this shit. Do you know what it's like to stab someone?
Yeah, homie, what's your name?
Will.
Oh, I'm Malachi.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Hey.
Nice to meet you, Will.
What's up?
What up?
Yeah, what's up, man?
I'm Will.
It hurts.
Hold on, we can feel exposed.
Damn, check this out. This is my trick. Hey, that was pretty tight.
That was pretty sick. That was pretty sick. Hey, man, can you shut up?
Crush my
Awesome.
was young, my uncle used to try to convince me that when he was in high school, he dated Angelina Jolie. I was like, dude, you're fucking tripping. Like, I vividly remember him showing me, like, the box for Wanted. And he's like, see that girl? And I was like, yeah. He's like, I dated her back in the day. I was like, okay, sure, Danny. You're a fucking idiot.
So
thank you so much.
I'm okay. Thank you, though.
Actually, yes, please.
I think you have a problem.
What's my problem?
A lot of things.
Too much coffee.
There's too much conflict going on.
Too much coffee going on?
But we'll just text him.
What do you say?
He said he needs to be scooped. And he's asking for a place to stay. I'm gonna let him know he can stay at my place. But we're gonna have to go get his ass. Because I think he's just kind of waiting around somewhere.
Now?
Yeah, like right now.
Alright.
Are you fine with that?
Yeah.
Alright, let's get it.
Okay.
Like right now?
Like right now.
Right.
Right now.
But when though?
Now. Got you.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
What up, y'all?
I'm gonna grab some inside.
Y'all doing good? Oh, yeah.
Hey, man.
What up, dude?
City folk just don't get it.
Now pretty much all that's left is a waiting game.
You're probably the best chef in all of Motor City.
What's up, Motor City?
Motor City is wherever you're at.
Motor City is a state of mind.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Mm-hmm. S'mores.
Yeah, I still want to see.
What the fuck?
It's all my brain right now.
How about your ankle?
It's not good.
Is it purple yet?
It's not purple yet, but it's lumping.
It'll get there. Tomorrow you wake up, it's gonna be swollen fucking purple. Shit.
I'm so pissed, dude.
Let's put it in some Epsom salt.
Mm-hmm. That's what I was about to say. Minor
There's
little
baths in the dorm room, though.
Oh, yeah. He's just gonna get a tub and soak his foot.
Oh, yeah.
A nice bucket. A like bucket. Home Depot or something.
Yeah, get warm water all up in there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, right. That would go so good.
What's the hand formation that y'all are doing?
Yeah.
You have to prevent any air from escaping, except for through your thumb. You want a little sliver, and then you blow into it like a bottle. You know how a glass bottle, you hold it out the car window and you gotta be level with it, so you angle your hand like that.
How's your morning going?
It's going good. How's yours, dude?
Just chilling.
Thanks for letting me stay at your place, dude.
Dude, anytime. Honestly, it does not matter. If you're coming through here, just hit me up.
I appreciate that, dude. Oh, look, a cat.
So where is it you're headed?
Just going wherever I can get to, wherever I can put my board down.
It's fair.
I might stay, I have no idea.
Well, it's a peaceful place to settle down.
Yeah.
Especially this little area.
Oh, yeah.
Some of my homies call it Little Colorado.
It's kind of like that, that's pretty sick. I like the city more, though. More people.
More going on.
Yeah. It feels less stagnant.
No, you definitely feel stagnant here.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you're willing to travel.
Yeah, for sure, dude. I like moving.
And getting to a city would probably be it.
Mm-hmm. And plus skateboarding's like biggest thing in my life, honestly. I want to do it for as long as I can.
I don't blame you. It's like just a distraction from everything else going on.
Oh, yeah.
You're just entirely focused in the moment.
Yeah.
And that's how it should be, just in the moment.
Mm-hmm.
What you doing, baby? You gonna hit one more spot before you head out?
For sure.
Alright, let's get it.
I'm taking this cat with me. Is it on?
Yeah, it's recording.
I can't see that. Who am I talking to?
People.
I can't see
them. No, they're inside the camera.
In here?
They're inside.
That's not possible.
No, they're watching you. It's like you're God. Give your message to the people.
They're in there?
Yes, they're in there.
I can't see them. Hello? Who's this going to?
I'm sorry. This isn't the legacy I wanted to leave behind. In the coming minutes, I'll be stripped not only of my life, but of my life's work, my manifesto. I've constantly found myself in an uncontrollable and always increasing state of hopelessness, caused by none other than God's greatest creation, mankind. I tried. I pushed myself to find enjoyment in things. I did well in school. I strove for enlightenment and higher education, but I found my scholastic years wasted, mixed in with young scholars and their vacuous bumper stickers, their social media posts about religion or politics, but lowest of all seemed to be their care for the environment. They'd say, save this, save that, eat this, not that, but the less you know, the more you think you know. In college, unfortunately, I found this trend to be celebrated by both my peers and professors. This forged leap of confidence that could get them anything they wanted. And in their case, they wanted attention. I didn't want any of that. So I escaped. I found purpose in the simple things. You know, people like to call it selfish, but I call it free will. I lived off the land, and I was healthy, mentally and physically. I was alone. I was happy. Yet this unfamiliar feeling came and went. God's greatest creation, mankind. A virus. Mother Nature is gonna burn us out. My purpose? To aid her.
Wait. No! Stop!
That uncontrollable and always increasing state of hopelessness. I couldn't shake it. Guess it got me too, in its own way. For what it's worth, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mother, for all of us. God's greatest creation. I guess we let both our parents down. I weep for you. I was your defender. Now, I'm your martyr.
Here's your change. Have a nice night.
Don't tell me what to do.
Next. Sir, you come in here every night and I tell you the same thing. You cannot buy a lottery ticket without paying first.
Honest lottery ticket, please.
This bill is fake and ripped. Get the fuck out of here before I call the police.
Look, I'm trying to make ends meet. I was like you once. Pretty.
Yeah, I'm sure. You got about 10 seconds before I call the police.
I'm not moving.
Sir, if I promise to buy you a lottery ticket, will you please stop holding the lineup? Anyone you want. Go ahead.
Miss, don't waste your money on me.
Well, I've done my good deed for the year.
You have a coin I can use?
Here.
Next.
Finally, the line is complete.
Insert cash or select payment type.
I can't believe it. I actually won.
Ignore him. There's no way. Give me that. Well, I'll be damned.
What the fuck? Where are all those lights coming from?
A ticket is worth 500 grand before taxes.
500 grand?
Grand means hell.
I know what grand means. That money is mine, and you know it. Oh, shut the fuck up. Now you want to play devil's advocate?
Stand out. Find any other survivors.
You know, it was my squad leader that your friend killed.
Are you gonna kill me?
We'll see.
Do you even know where you are?
Just be quiet.
Give it to me.
Huh?
Toss it over here. Toss it.
So you're not helping me?
Oh, well, I'm helping you all right. I'm helping you to not get yourself killed.
What do you want, mister?
I want you to put your hands up where I can see them. Put them up. Up. Now, very slowly, I want you to walk out of that creek. Come on.
Put your hands out.
Closer.
Yeah. This is all.
That'll keep you all from running off. And no more fighting now, you hear?
What the hell is this?
Well, call it a little enforced neutrality. But pick that fishing gear up.
I'm not going anywhere with her.
Fuck you.
Well, y'all welcome to wander around with them handcuffs on all night if that's what you'd rather do.
Where are you taking us?
My camp.
Can I ask why?
Well, it's about all I got left since your ward dropped an explosive shell in my house.
Wasn't our fault. It was probably their side.
Your people hit civilians all the time.
Doesn't matter whose shell it was. If there'd been no war, there wouldn't have been no shell.
So what do you want with us?
I just always thought that what y'all needed was a chance to talk things out.
You can't be serious.
All right, now y'all get acquainted while I go fix us up some supper.
Fuck!
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pasture.
Like that's gonna help.
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff,
they beat me when I disobey.
Do you mind?
Actually, yeah. I've had that bunk crammed down my throat for a lifetime. Thanks.
Teaches important lessons.
Those lessons are just there to keep you in line.
You people only want to listen to yourselves.
Not like you have anything new to say.
You know, you're exactly like every Gressivist I ever met.
Well, maybe you notice more about people if you opened your mind up.
You're insane. You'd have to be to believe all that stuff.
You can't keep everything the same.
The truth isn't one thing today and another thing tomorrow.
How can you make progress by clinging to the
past? Destroying our way of life is not progress.
You're a dog afraid to leave its goddamn cage.
Hey.
I will kill you before I let y'all kill each other. Understand? Y'all can live together when you have to.
Why do we have to?
This is how you learn how to get along.
Look around, Virgil. No one wants to meet halfway anymore.
Well, I do. That's what this country's for.
The country's dead, Virgil. It's dead, and it's not coming back.
I don't accept that.
Well, you better start liking the idea.
I think I'd rather go on fighting forever than go back to living with them.
You say that now. Do you even have any idea what this war is for?
I know what my duty is.
A lot of ordinary people died. Starved out, shelled, murdered because they was on the wrong side. You think they knew anything about duty?
It's a fucking war, Virgil. It happens all the time. I know about it.
Then why let it go on?
So we can win? So it means something?
You think anybody wins at the end of all this?
Maybe.
People in my town, that's all that they talked about. No matter how hard I tried to talk sense into them, no matter how hard I tried to get them to talk things out, I didn't care anymore about law, justice. Just as their side won.
I'd say they were right.
They butchered each other. Everyone. I was a sheriff and I couldn't protect them. I couldn't protect them from themselves. Y'all have a good night now here.
You know, you're not wrong. I mean, it's hard now, but it'll be worth it.
You won't be saying that when you lose.
Maybe not. But isn't just the possibility enough?
Don't do that. I'm not like you.
We're both fighting for what matters to us.
So what?
Kind of comes from the same place, doesn't it?
I guess.
So what are you fighting for?
I wouldn't expect someone like you to understand. You?
Nah. You just make fun of me.
Fine. Whatever.
Good night.
Yeah. Good night.
Not much further now. Just dead ahead.
Why'd you bring us here?
Your army's been having it out all morning. Sounds like they're getting closer.
Why are we here? We're gonna get shot.
Well, that's up to you. You two don't get to leave here until you find some kind of common ground. Until we're all in the ground, whichever comes first.
You're crazy.
Isn't it you people always saying something about desperate times? Desperate measures?
Why do you care about us?
I need to know that there's something at the end of all this.
This isn't a game, Virgil.
It's no use talking to someone who won't listen.
Then why don't you try listening first?
I've dealt with people like you my whole life.
Go on.
I don't know what to say to you. You're on the wrong side. You're anti-human.
You don't know the first thing about being human. You say you're for the people. What about us? Aren't we people?
What's that?
You wouldn't get it?
Try me.
My mother gave this to me. It's been our family for generations.
So they'd be with you?
So I'd know I was fighting for.
What do you mean?
People are always trying to tell me I'm backwards. Everything I ever loved or cared about was all wrong. Anti-human. What would you do?
I don't know.
What's that?
It's nothing.
Doesn't seem like it.
I made it with my friends when they took me in.
Took you in? What about your family?
They don't care about me. They only cared that I did as I was told, and punishing me when I didn't. So I ran away. Became my own person.
I guess I can understand why. So where are your friends now?
I don't know.
Well, I hope you see them again.
Thanks. I hope you get back to your family.
Well, maybe there's some hope for us after all. Y'all take care now. And if you ever need me, I'm always around.
So who you think's winning?
I don't know. I guess we should get back down there.
I figure I've done enough fighting for the day.
I guess it couldn't hurt to sit here for a while.
Just like to thank everyone for coming out tonight. As a little reminder, we meet every Tuesday at 8. My name is Mark, and I look forward to getting to know everyone here, especially the new ones. Feel like introducing yourself?
I'm good.
It's okay to be nervous. I mean, we've all been there.
Hi, I'm Jesse. I'm here for the same reason as all of you. I like to drink.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. Mom was a drunk. Dad was a drunk after mom left, especially. Guess it runs in the family.
You guys have a good night.
Thanks, you too.
See you next week, right?
See you.
Hey, Jesse. Thanks for sharing. Listen, if you ever need anything, you can reach out to me, okay?
Thanks.
I know how hard it can be. You just gotta keep trying, okay? Be all right. Who's got 1 month? Congratulations, Jesse. I am really proud of you guys. It takes a lot to come in every day. I see a lot of faces that don't come back and it kills me. But you guys are consistent. You made me proud. You should make yourselves proud, and these coins are proof of that.
See you next week, Mark.
Yeah.
Jesse. I'm happy to see you, Jesse. Your dad said that you've been going to the meetings. That's good. A month? That's great.
Get to the point. Why are you here?
Because it worked for me. And I think it can work for you.
How?
I want you to meet my family.
No thanks, Mom. As you guys know, I haven't seen my mom in a few years. A couple weeks ago, she found me. She wants to help. She wants me to meet her family.
How does that make you feel?
Like shit. Why would I want to meet them? Why was I not good enough for her, but they are?
Hey, Jesse.
Yeah?
I think you should take that invite.
Why?
So it might actually do you some good. These meetings only do so much. Listen, I've seen some guys go through some awful shit, and they get through it. You can too. It's just gonna take some work. But hey, I believe in you. Alright?
What if it doesn't work?
Can't know that. You just gotta try it. You might be surprised. Listen, just try it for me, okay?
Okay.
Jesse, come on in.
Thanks.
Bruce is setting the table now.
Okay.
So you're at almost 2 months now.
Yeah, next week.
That's great.
Thanks.
Did you know your mother was at 2 months when we met?
Oh, honey, don't bore him with that story. Okay. We're here for him, not us.
Oh, it's okay, I promise. Sorry.
No, it's, you can learn all about that later. For now, we're just glad you're here.
This chicken is really good.
Oh, Bruce is such a good cook. You're lucky Trey isn't here, or you'd barely get a bite.
Is that your son?
Yes, you probably saw a picture of him in the hallway.
I'm sorry he wasn't here, Jesse, but he's at a friend's.
He sure is excited to meet you.
Really?
He's excited to have a big brother.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not his big brother.
Oh, is there a problem? We didn't mean to offend.
No.
Sorry, I just meant not comfortable with that.
Yeah, not yet. After a few months and you get to know him, I think you will.
I said I'm not comfortable with that.
I'm sorry.
No, it's all right, hon. I get it, Jesse. I know how it is in recovery. I know what you're going through.
No, you don't.
Jesse, I've been sober 5 years, I understand. You just can't keep blaming other people for your addictions.
I'm not blaming anyone else for my addictions. I'm just saying
I'm
not comfortable
with that.
Please, just can we please change the subject?
You need to...
Why change the subject now? You know?
Let us help you, son.
Bruce, please.
I'm not your son.
Jesse, please drop it.
No. I'm sick and tired of you trying to parent me.
That is our job, Jesse.
I'm not your kid. And you don't get to decide to be my mom now.
She was a different person back then. She's a great mother for Trey.
Well, she should have been that for me. Why was I the one who got the mom who was always too hungover to give a shit, or I would find face down in the puddle of her own vomit? You know what? Actually, fuck this.
Jesse?
Mark? What the fuck are you doing here?
Same thing you are, it looks like.
You shouldn't be here, you're my sponsor.
Yeah. I just needed one last drink. Just needed a break, you know?
Fuck this.
Joe! I'm just having one last drink.
brought the Yingling? I want to know.
It's not me.
It was you.
What?
Yes, it was.
Yo, it was not me. It was you. Bro, not me. It was my friend. I swear. I don't buy this shit. I mean, I just, I go.
I like it though.
Yeah, right. I like it.
You would like it.
Yeah, what are you talking about? This is a pretty
movie. I would rather have.
You like Bush Light, man.
Don't shut the hell up.
Listen, I don't want to hear this. I don't want to hear this.
What are the best beats? I need to know.
Bush Light.
What? 60? 60? Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Come on, man.
Yeah, I'll call. Fuck it. Raise the baby.
I hate this game.
Come on, man. What you doing?
My bad.
What's it gonna be, buddy?
Yeah, man, this dude was attractive, but I didn't expect him to pull some shit like that. We went to Wild's for dinner. Dude fucking ordered surf and turf on the first date. I mean, I'm not broke, but come on, bro.
You didn't split the check?
Of course not. It was my idea to go there, and I wanted to take him out, but I didn't expect him to pull some shit like that.
Did he put out?
Of course. You think your boy didn't smash after buying a goddamn filet mignon? Come on.
I figured.
Damn right. What about you, man? Weren't you talking to somebody?
Yeah. But it just didn't make sense to me.
What do you mean?
I don't know, dude.
Just not your type, huh?
I don't know.
Well, what's your type?
I don't really have a type.
I got you. Whatever you can get, you know?
Yeah.
That sounds awful.
It was pretty awful.
What happened after that?
I can't believe it either. And when I was cleaning it up,
it was
our first time, and I don't know. I think I had a sexual experience with this man. And
how's it going, buddy boy?
I think I'm good.
You think you're good? You either know or you either are or you aren't.
I'm not bad.
Well, that's good.
Okay, just because he's not bad doesn't mean he's fucking good. Okay, he could be fucking terrible.
Are you terrible?
No. No, I'm not terrible.
Well, that's also good.
No. Look, there's different stages between good and bad.
Which stage are you in, Theo?
I'm glad you asked, Milo. I'm ecstatic. You know, far, far beyond generically what we would call good, you know?
That's great.
Something akin to great. I agree, Milo.
Well, if you're great, I suppose I'm good.
That's good.
I didn't ask. How are you, Milo?
Absolutely dreadful. Dinner's ready, boys.
Thomas, you smoking tonight?
I'm good.
All right, man. I'll be packing another after this, so I'll let you know.
Thanks.
Greenhorn!
This guy.
Do you think your friends will like me?
I don't know why they wouldn't. Why wouldn't they?
Because I don't think your other friends like me very much.
Yeah, well, it's not like my friends are interesting or important people. You know my friend Marty. He used to be a lot of fun. But ever since he got domesticated, he's become a bore.
Then why are we going?
We shouldn't. Let's forget about it and go see a movie. I heard this one out now about these nuns who are lesbians.
Well, we already said we would go, so we might as well. I'm starving anyways.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, how's it going? Hey. Looking good. Love my mafioso kind of jacket.
That's great.
Yeah,
that's funny.
Good. Where's
hey, right there.
Martin, nice to meet you. It's a pleasure. Yeah. Come on, sit down.
How's your wife?
She's good, Leslie.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Hello.
Did you hear about this new lesbian nun movie?
I heard it's one of Clint Eastwood's best in years. It's how it changed from my Hollywood sensibilities.
I'm not allowed to see it, so once you do, just tell me it's awful, and I can feel a lot better about myself.
Sure.
It's not like I commanded you that you couldn't see it. I just don't think we should pay for such filth, honey.
Anyway. Oh. I was at the post office the other day, and I ran into. Do you remember that woman? Excuse me, I'm telling a story.
Yes, I would like to start with the salad. I would like the Caesar, but no croutons. If you have croutons on there, I will send it back.
That was great. So you tell me you interrupted my anecdote so that you could order your stupid croutonless salad?
I don't understand why you can't finish your little antidote after I order my stupid salad. You can easily start from the beginning after we all order.
Okay. So anyway, thank you so much. We love this place. Good to see you. We're gonna get going. It's always, always expected to see you. Come on, let's go.
What are you laughing for?
I just didn't think we were gonna get out of that so easy. Huh? Come on.
Did you plan anything else for tonight?
You know how I am with plans. What is it?
Let's go to a party. Come on, I think you would enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
got another?
Have you smoked before? Here, watch me. Now, why do we even bother if you can't figure out how to smoke on your own? So what are you doing at this party then?
I was invited.
Go to every party you're invited to?
No. Do you go to every college party that you're invited to?
Well, it's my first one, actually. I don't even think I was invited. Will you at least allow me to explain myself?
Wait for me. I left something.
Did your friends all abandon you upstairs?
No, I just wanted to leave a bit earlier than everyone else.
Do you want to ride? Wherever you're going? Home?
All right.
You know, I didn't mean to see you tonight. But because I did, I've been thinking back on our lives and some of the mistakes that I made. And, you know what I mean. When I saw you, this rush of memories came back to me. And I remembered you as this little kid who would go running around the house and you'd scrape your knee and you'd come over to me so that I could make you feel better. It was easy then to make you feel better. But now, I don't know what to do.